episode was a mess because I ran out of lives in Rusty Bucket Bay. So I'm saving that level till the end. I'm not gonna go back into it until I'm done with the Let's Play, pretty much. Until I need the last few jiggies. Because you actually have to enter every single world. But if it comes down to it, I am totally freaking skipping that level. Because there's no way that I'm gonna deal with losing all of my lives again. Because that's the first time I've ever gotten a game over in this game. I've never gotten a game over before. The only time that Let's Player's Curse actually affects me, it figures. Anyway, now that the water's raised all the way, we should be able to... Yes! Okay. We can now access this level. Thank God we have enough notes. I'd be really mad if we didn't have enough notes. Like, oh my gosh, I would kill someone. That's right, only gold feathers kill these things. Just gotta watch how many gold feathers I use, although I won't need any more anymore. Grunty never got to finish her sentence. Now, the last level, I nearly spoiled, I think, twice in my Let's Play. It's pretty much... It's not as hard as the last one. The last one was... shouldn't have been that hard. The one time I was gonna make it, but then I fell off. I fell off the platform down to the bottom, which made it literally impossible, because when you make it there, you have just barely enough time to... collect yourself. Collect all the items. Still really upset about that. I'm recording this right after the last two episodes. I was like, game over, I'm done. I quit. I'm finished. Under normal circumstances, I would just do the rest of the level and come back, but the fact that if you die, you lose everything destroys the point of that, because if I die with 96 notes, I'd have to go through, which I have done before. I had 97, actually. 97 notes, and I died. I had to go through the entirety of the final level. Again. Twice, actually. The first time, I just... I died with 97 notes. The second time I had 96 and couldn't figure out where the last four are. Or were. Where am I going? I don't think I showed this off at the beginning of the Let's Play. But there's a tunnel down here in this pool of water. Turn. It leads to a jiggy room that was pointless because you can't access it until the very end of the game. I hope I have enough. Oh gosh. Yeah, I have enough. Okay. Alright, that thoroughly scared me. I thought that I might not have enough jiggies to unlock this level. Click clock wood. Oh, and I think there's a Brentilda, but I think there's a Mumbo token around here somewhere. Nope. Not there. Oh, crap. Oh, no. I might have to go back into Rusty Bucket Bay. Because you need 25. I guess maybe just skip the engine room and do the rest of the... that is terrible. Alright, I guess I'm just gonna skip the engine room and do the rest of the level first. And hope that I don't die in the engine room and lose all of my notes and have to go through the entire freaking level again. Because that would not make me a happy person. There's things that just don't make me a happy person. That's one of them. Running out of lives does not make me a happy person. Ouch. I really, really, really wish that I didn't have to do this. What's over here? Hey, look, I broke something. Oh, I know what this is. I don't need to bother with this. Right, I gotta find the door now. Can't believe I'm going back. After all the trouble that it gave me, and I'm going back. I'm just gonna do the rest of the level, though. Because there's no point in even trying if I know for sure that I'm gonna die again. Screw this level. I feel like I have never done the game without cheating, but I know I have. But like, I guess I feel like I cheated last time because I did that room. First try, actually, I think. I'm nearly certain. Yeah, I did do it first try. I remember now. I remember exactly what happened. Pretty much the whole Let's Play went flawlessly. I never made a single mistake until Rusty Bucket Bay, where I beat the engine room first try, and I'm like, oh my gosh, there's no way that that's ever gonna happen to me ever again, because that literally, like, that is the hardest jiggy in the game, and I got it first try. I was, first off, completely flabbergasted that I could possibly do that, but it proved to me that I know that there was no way that I was gonna be able to, do it again, ever. I might, like, look back into my Facebook and pull it up and, like, record a little clip of it and put it in here. But basically, in case I don't, for whatever reason, which is possible, I beat the engine room first try, 100%, everything, first try, and I was like, wow, that's never gonna happen to me ever again, and I was right. The rest of the Let's Play went terrible for me. I died against Grunty twice, I think. Oh, crap, there's notes over there. Like, normally, I do the engine room first and then do the rest of the level, but I don't like engine room at all. I really, really, really hate the engine room, actually. Why did I just go down there? That was weird. That is a strange sound. Oh yeah, another thing. All of the water now takes away my air twice as fast. I just realized there's a ladder over here that I just swam past. This is the best thing you could do in the water, is jump and flutter, or whatever you want to call it. Because that minimizes your time in the water, and you actually move faster in the water that way. I think there's notes along this. I can't believe that I had died there so many times. I've never, ever had that much trouble with, Rusty Bucket. Whoa! Rusty Bucket Bay before. So, you could say I have fond memories. At least, like, all of the Jinjos in this level are really, really easy to get to. Mm-hmm. Maybe I'll just, like... Maybe I used up all of the luck in my entire life in just that one spot. Alrighty. Hey, I passed my note score. The problem is, there's so many notes in the stupid room. Oh, total is 4. I don't even know why there's that many notes in that room, but there is! There's so many notes in that room. There shouldn't be, either. That's the worst part, is there's like, probably 5% of the notes in that. There's more than 5%. There's like 20% of the notes. And I'm gonna try the engine room, and I'm gonna die with like 96 notes. Guaranteed. And then I'm gonna have to go through the entire level again. Just to get it. Just to get the 100% thing. I literally, like, I cannot believe that I just died there. There was something up against my foot. I don't know what it was. It felt like a cord, but it was, squishy. So I'm hoping it wasn't a mouse. Eggs. If you put up with the crap of all these guys, you get a life. Ouch. Life! Nothing in this corner? Alright. Banjo-Kazooie used to feel like a really easy game, but it doesn't feel easy today. I've never, ever had this much trouble with it. And that's just all I'm going to talk about this whole episode, is complaining about how I died when I shouldn't have. I forget where he is. He's in like one of these crevices back here. I think he might be actually back here. Yep. I think there's also a Jiggy in here. No, maybe not. Yeah, I guess not. I forgot that that's all that was in there, was a blue Jinjo and some lower collectibles. How do I... Oh yeah, that's right, okay. I guess I have to work my way onto the boat now. Don't fall in the water. I'm okay with having to work my way over there, because, then I can do all of the stuff except for the engine room on the ship. You actually can, beat the engine room with, or beat the, get that Jiggy without turning off the fans, like, hitting one switch but not the other. It's just like how I did that one part earlier, where I, pretty much, like, just ignored... Oh, no! Are you serious? Why do I fall off of everything? At least I'm doing this before Click Clock Wood. My hand is sweaty like crazy. Oh, I'm out of time. Alright, I guess... Thank you all for watching. I am Ninja Spaghetti, and I'll see y'all in the next video.